What a cruel irony that the amazing work from the scientific community in South Africa has led to such severe action on a global basis and travel to and from. Do you, I mean, you're no politician and you perhaps don't want to go there on that, but do you think actually the reaction from international companies and countries has been proportionate?
I think it was a knee-jerk reaction without actually looking at the signs. If one looks at the signs of transmission of these viruses, it's very clear that closing borders or restricting movement ultimately has very, very little impact on whether a virus or a new variant of the virus will ultimately spread. And so in the end, it is discriminatory what has happened, discriminatory against our country. As you say, I'm no economist either, but I know that we're losing billions of pounds every day because of what has happened over the last week.
Yeah, but I guess the point here is, and you used the word, I noticed, ultimately, countries just seem to want to slow down the pace of that, the spread of it. And as you say, the COVID-19 variants will not respect borders, but they may be able to slow down that transmission across borders and buy populations more time, perhaps, to get vaccinated. Do you think that's a fair assumption?
I think the approach is to vaccinate as many people as possible right now is the right approach. And I think that was also the approach that that our president Cyril Ramaphosa took last night in his address. It is really important that the world gets vaccinated, because if there is virus circulating in the world, or we will have new variants that will emerge, such as this one. And also, of course, the vaccines prevent severe disease and death. And we think that even though there are some mutations in this virus that suggest some immune escape or escape from the vaccines, that the vaccines would still work in these settings, yes.
Professor Hanekom, difficult question to answer, but why has South Africa only fully vaccinated circa 24% of its population?
So South Africa was very late to come on board. I think initially, in the first year, our government had very little in terms of planning for vaccination. But when it did come on board, it went so at full steam, and that was earlier this year. And it started very, very good. Everything happened in a very expedited fashion. But right now, we are actually experiencing an extraordinary amount of apathy or vaccine hesitancy in our population. We literally have tens of millions of dosages that we have available to give, and somehow our vaccine drives have not been as successful as they should be. So I think, once again, I think it's the right thing to now put absolutely every effort into trying within South Africa to get vaccines out.